Be willing. Be willing to do whatever it is that God leads you to do. We said week one, there's this very dangerous prayer, right? And not just search me, but lead me. Because the decisions that led to my biggest regret, I wasn't following Jesus' lead, right? And so to change that, to avoid future regrets, we have to do something different. We have to be willing to follow his lead. It says in Proverbs 3:6, seek his will in all you do, and he will show you which path to take. It's great advice. If you want God to speak to you, to give you direction, seek his words, and then go down the path they lead. Not just let him speak, say, oh, good news, God, but actually be willing to do something. Let him set the agenda in your life. Let him set the agenda in your prayer life. Be willing to let him guide you. What if instead of going to and talking to God with our laundry list of things, we went with a blank sheet of paper and our Bible and just said, God, what do you want to say to me? What do you want to show me? Help me see. And then be willing to do it. Ask him to show you the path to take. Right? God, show me the sin in my life. This is part of search me. God, speak to me. Right? Search me and then speak to me. Show me where I need to repent. Right? God, how can I better love my spouse? Show me what they need. How can I be somebody who doesn't just go to church, but help me be the church? God, where can I use my gifts to help reach and teach people to live and love like Jesus? Here's a quick prayer for you. Does God want me to serve at Searchlight Church? Spoiler alert, yes. God wants you to use your gifts to honor him and love other people. God, what can I do to bless somebody? Where can I be generous? What do I have that can be used to bless others? God, who is it today that needs an encouragement from you? Show me someone who needs to know you today. And just be willing to hear from him in your prayer time. Whatever you do, when you pray, make sure that you're willing to obey, because there's nothing worse than asking somebody to tell you something and then completely ignoring them. In fact, sometimes we feel like we haven't heard anything new from God. I don't know if you've ever had this experience where you're like, you went through a season, you really felt like you were hearing God, and he was telling you what to do, and you were clicking, and you felt really like, you know, this bold spirituality, and then it's been like a couple months, and you feel like, well, I don't hear anything new, God. I feel like, where'd you go? Did you go silent? And here's the thing. Sometimes God gives us something to do, and he won't give us something new until we already do what he said. Right? When we're talking to God, he's like, hey, remember last month when I put my finger on that thing? Still haven't dealt with it. Hey, you remember last time when you asked me to speak and I told you exactly what I wanted you to do and you keep trying to find a way around it? God's not going to give us what's next if we're not faithful with what's now. And so when we pray, God, would you speak to me? We have to be willing to actually do what he's put on our heart, to take the first step, and then he'll reveal the next step of the path. That's what faith is. It's walking when you can't see everything. It's moving without seeing the whole picture, a willingness to walk with God even when you can't see. Be willing to do what God has spoken to your heart. Here's the other thing. Don't ask God to speak if you aren't willing to move, right? Don't ask him to speak if you aren't willing to hear him, and don't ask God to speak if you aren't willing to move. If you're asking God to respond to you, are you willing to follow through when he speaks? I was thinking about how important follow-through is. Eric and I will be married 9 years in June, 6/9/12. That's how I remember it. I'm a big dummy. I need it to be simple numbers. 6/9/12, we'll be married 9 years. And it all started with me asking her for a response. I needed her to speak to me because I asked a question, right? November the 10th, 2010, I got down on one knee. Again, here at the Long Branch Beach, it was very cold. We were watching the sunrise. It was like foamy waves. I know she was like counting down the time till we were done. And I got on one knee, and I asked her for a response. I needed to hear her response. And so I'm literally sitting there. My world has stopped. Tell me an answer. I'm waiting with bated breath. I need you to speak to me. How awkward would it be if she said, yes, my answer is yes. I will respond to you. Here is what you need to do next. Let's join our hearts and our lives forever. And I was like, oh, no. Like, I just wanted to know where you were. Like, I wanted to know your feelings. Like, I wanted to know your input. I'm glad we're kind of on the same page, but I'm not ready for anything like that yet. I just wanted to know where you were. Glad we're on the same page, right? Want to get some breakfast? Baby, where are you going? Like, you can't ask for somebody to speak to you and then ignore actually following through with them. That would be ridiculous. That makes no sense. But sometimes we do that with God. Speak to me, and I'm willing to do what it takes once I hear from you. Once you respond to me, once you answer me, once you tell me what to think, I will be willing to do it. And it's not often that we don't know what God is saying. It's just so often it's hard to do it.